quick preview of what my toolbox looks like right now. It's super faded, and there's actually some rust spots coming up on it, like right here and there. And it's just got that super faded look from the sun just beating down on it on the front, and scratched, scuffed, and scratched. So we're gonna paint it, and I'll show you a before and after. Here's the before of it. It's all of it scratched and buffed up, but mostly the top here, that's super faded, that I want to get that black look back to. I did a quick test and I wiped it down with alcohol. If you can see the difference from this faded surface to this nice black, that's just a single coat. Okay, so I just threw a bunch of rubbing alcohol over the top of it. That's why it's all shiny right now. I don't think I'll have to buff it or sand it down, just because it's already so dulled so much, the paint's already faded so much. And I only have 60 grit, so it'll just scratch the shit out of it, and I don't want to do that. So I'm just gonna do another coat of this rubbing alcohol and really thin it up, maybe some paint thinner or acetone, and then we're gonna do a coat of black on the top and show you how, you guys, it looks. All right, so this is after first coat. It's dry to the touch, but still wet, if you know what I mean. I was able to get, with the 2.5 cans I had, I was able to get the whole top section of the toolbox and the side, just these side rails and the front rail. And then I ran out, as you can see, I started spraying and I ran out for this main section. I decided I wanted to tape off the chrome handles and the Husky chrome logo, and then just real quick, I just, instead of unbolting those are just some eye bolts on both sides, I just covered them real quick because the paint right there doesn't need to be touched up too much. But yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna get another can of paint and we'll throw it on there. So yeah, I'll get back to you with that update. All right, you guys, just applied the second coat to it. It's looking good. It's honestly coming out really. I got the high gloss Rust-Oleum. Let me show you what kind of paint I'm using. This right here, Rust-Oleum high gloss is the paint and primer. Anyways, but second coat's on, drying right now. I did the front part, cleaned up all those scuffs and scratches that you can't really see anymore. But yeah, looks, it's coming together. So I had quick look on the inside. So one issue I ran into, so originally, this has been mounted in 3 of my trucks, and I bought it from a guy used who had it in his truck. So through all the trucks it's been mounted, there's been quite a few holes. I only drilled a couple because I only do little tiny mounts. I never do big old bolts, but he had big old bolt holes in his, and that comes from the factory, I believe, for clamp. Anyways, to cover those up, because I'm really trying to clean this toolbox up, I cut some toolbox liner, but my toolbox liner is only 18 inches and I need it to be like 18 3/4, hence my gap up here. I mean, kind of sucks that it's not all the way, but I mean, for the most part, covers up everything. I think it cleans up. Did that to both sides. So I just gotta get it seated down. Carpet I already had in there, just kinda keeps any oils that I have in here that spill, just kinda cleans it up. I did trim it, if you've seen it on my last toolbox. I don't know if I included the interior, but I trimmed it out before. It was just a big piece of carpet. So I trimmed it to size. I've been wiping out the inside, and then I mounted this magnet with some bolts and nuts on the back. So this is just a magnet to hold tools, but honestly, I don't know if it'll hold going down the road, holding the tools after I put them on there. So we'll see how that does. And anyways, let's see if we can get focus, there we go. Turned out really well, especially the top part. This had quite a bit of sun just bleach to it, you know, it was just beat down. The scratches weren't as big as a deal, but also they didn't really, let's see if I can find them. See right here, that's a scratch, and you can still see the scratches. Obviously I knew that was gonna happen, but you can't tell from a distance, and it's got a really good gloss to it again, like it's brand new. I'm happy that I taped these off and kept them the chrome or silver, if you will, that I had them in. So yeah, it turned out really well. Cleaned up the inside and organized it, so got everything all organized in there. But yeah, I'm super, super happy with that good gloss look across the whole thing. But let's get a side thing here. Point him down. There it is. All right, let's call that a wrap for the day. I think that went really well. I'm gonna have to let you guys know how it holds up, but I had used this exact paint in the past, this Universal Gloss Rust-Oleum. It's kind of expensive paint, but it holds up well. I used it on my A-frame for work, and I mean, I was working in there, throwing marble on it every day, and it held up. So I know for a fact that it's good paint, but we'll have to see how it holds up to. I live in Utah. We'll have to see how it holds up to the Utah heavy snows and lots of sun in the summer. We'll see after 1 year how it holds up and stuff, and you know, I'll have to update you guys, but it definitely looks a lot better than it did. I'll throw up some pictures right now once I'm done talking here of before and after pictures, but I mean, it's a huge noticeable difference, but maybe I'm thinking next video, if you guys are interested, I'm just gonna do a video of what I keep in my truck toolbox, of some of the tools I like to keep and carry, and some of the like emergency stuff I like to just have on hand. And then I also need to redo my bed liner in my truck. So those are some videos I have of thoughts of what I want to do next. Let me know if you guys prefer one or the other, or both of them sound dumb as shit, and I won't do either. So, cheers, you guys, and we'll see you next time. And good night to you if you're watching this at night. But good morning, maybe you're watching it tomorrow. Some time, write this rhyme with a beautiful woman like you in mind. Baby, be mine, I'm trying to find what makes you tick. Can we talk, maybe walk around the park? Trust me, girl, I stand apart. All women ain't bitches and all men are dogs, even though we bark. Cause I just wanna get to know you. Glossy that paint turned out. The Rust-Oleum gloss. The gloss, really like a gloss. Glossy, I know a gloss paint. The gloss, fuck man, I said that 10 times.